As curious beings, it's in our nature to wonder about the future. Even when we think about the past, it's only because we are hardwired to find patterns so we can better predict future outcomes. The driving force that shapes almost every aspect of the future of our civilization is technology. It's a gripping thought when you realise that for most of the time in human history, the lives of our ancestors were not that much different from their previous generation. The human species is about 200,000 years old, and most of that time, humans were hunters and gatherers. Even after we developed civilization, after the invention of agriculture, the lives of ordinary people living in, let's say, the first century of the Common Era, remained relatively unchanged compared to people living 1,000 years later. Civilization shifted into the next gear only when the Industrial Revolution kicked in. In a span of only 260 years after the first Industrial Revolution, technology transformed our lives more than ever before in the history of our species. Most science fiction movies portray the lives of people living in the future with fancy gadgets and equipment, fulfilling all of our needs by command. Perhaps the first technology to mimic such a scenario and make us feel like we are living in the future is going to be the use of XR, or extended reality. So, what is exactly XR? To better understand the prospects of extended reality and its applications, we first need to learn about its constituents. XR encompasses a conglomeration of virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality. First, let's take a look at the most familiar one, VR. Virtual reality is the use of computer technology to create a simulated experience that can be similar to, or completely different from, the real world. Standard virtual reality systems use either VR headsets or multi-projected environments to generate realistic visuals and sounds. The VR headset, with its user interface, offers you a digital experience that you can immerse yourself in any created 3D environment instead of just watching on a conventional 2D computer screen. Some early prototypes of virtual experiences predate even digital computing. Morton Helling wrote in the 1950s of an experience theatre that could encompass all the senses in an effective manner, drawing the viewer into the on-screen activity. In 1962, he built a prototype of his vision called Sensorama, along with 5 short films to be displayed in it while engaging multiple senses such as sight, sound, smell, and touch. Today, there are countless companies producing VR headsets. Among the most popular ones are Sony's PSVR, the standalone Oculus Quest, Valve Index, HTC Vive, etc. Obviously, gaming is the major industry propelling VR forward, but there are other fields beginning to incorporate virtual reality, such as education, medical training, and healthcare in general, the military, etc. If you want to learn more about this subject, we've uploaded a previous video solely dedicated to VR that's being suggested to you at the top right-hand corner. But next is augmented reality. In contrast to virtual reality, AR is an interactive experience of a real-world environment where the objects that reside in the real world are enhanced by computer-generated perceptual information across multiple, if not all, sensory modulates. AR can be defined as a system that fulfills 3 basic features: a combination of the real and virtual world, a real-time interaction, and accurate 3D registration of virtual and real objects. The overlaid sensory information can be constructive, additive to the natural environment, or it can be destructive, meaning the natural environment is masked to show virtual objects. In this way, augmented reality alters the perception of the real world, whereas VR completely replaces the user's real-world environment with a simulated one. There are many camera-based AR apps you can use with your smartphone right now. If you happen to own an iPhone, you can download the Measure app from the App Store for free. This app enables you to quickly measure the size of real objects, a person's height, and it can automatically provide the dimensions of rectangular ones. IKEA also came up with an AR app called IKEA Place, which lets you place virtual furniture in your house by simply taking a photograph of your physical space. Perhaps one of the best free AR apps out there is Jigspace. This app allows you to explore interactive 3D objects of just about anything. The library includes a mixture of fields such as machines, science, how-to, space, and even history. If you want a more in-depth video about this topic, check out our video about AR on your top right-hand corner. And finally, the last in our short list is mixed reality. MR is the merging of real and virtual worlds to produce new environments and visualizations, where physical and digital objects coexist and interact in real time. As the name implies, mixed reality is the mixing of the real and virtual world. MR does not exclusively take place in either the physical or the virtual world, but is rather a hybrid of the two. MR is similar to augmented reality, but there is a key difference. Mixed reality allows virtual overlay of graphics to interact with the real world. On February 2019, Microsoft released their new pair of mixed reality smart glasses called Hololens 2. In this showcase, they demonstrated their MR smart glasses with an application created with Unreal Engine. 2 months after the announcement, the Hololens 2 emulator also was made available to developers, which allows developers to create applications for this MR device. The Hololens 2 has a diagonal field of view of 52 degrees, with a resolution of 47 pixels per degree, improved hologram stability, new hardware, and accelerated workloads such as eye tracking, fully articulated hand tracking, semantic labeling, spatial audio, etc. However, this device is not currently meant for consumers, as its price is enormous, costing $3,500. In your top right-hand corner, you can find a more detailed video about MR. And there you have it, the three main realities that compose extended reality. That's why there is a need to improve this technology and come up with an XR device that encompasses all three realities. Instead of having a different device for each realm, a VR headset, an AR-compatible device, and an MR headset, the market will eventually produce an affordable device meant for consumers that has all realities. One device to rule them all. On May 2020, Qualcomm, the company that makes the chip for the Oculus Quest VR headset, came up with a huge announcement. They will start collaborating with 15 world-leading operators to deliver XR viewers. These operators plan to make XR part of their 5G offerings for consumers and enterprises within 2021. The XR viewers, as they call them, are lightweight, head-worn glasses that connect to a smartphone powered by Qualcomm's Snapdragon 855 or 865 mobile platforms. Tethered to a 5G-enabled smartphone via USB-C cable, XR viewers unlock a new generation of immersive experiences using 5G-enabled smartphones that provide high bandwidth and low latency, which is essential for high-quality XR. On their website, it states, "Consumers' favorite smartphone applications can become augmented reality experiences in front of their eyes, or workplace meetings can be revolutionized through holographic telepresence with virtual collaboration platforms. As XR and 5G come together to transform how the world connects, communicates, and consumes content. To protect the market of XR devices and ensure software and hardware optimization, Qualcomm has an XR-optimized certification program, which includes 6 degrees of freedom, head tracking performance on the viewer and smartphone, display calibration validation for the viewer, motion and photon latency validation on the viewer and smartphone, power and thermal test on the viewer and smartphone, interoperability between the viewer and smartphone. Within 1 to 4 years, they expect XR viewers to become wireless, while in the next 5 to 10 years, we will probably have 5G tethered glasses. NVIDIA. The tech company that designs GPUs is also focused on the development of XR technology. Their Cloud XR is their core platform for streaming virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality content from any open VR or XR application on a remote server, cloud, data, center, or edge. Whether rendering complex graphics, stitching together 360-degree video, or rendering volumetric scenes, the Cloud XR streaming stack lets developers leverage a flexible, high-performance cloud. nreal Light are the first lightwear mixed reality glasses that look like normal glasses, but offer the capability to blend in the both the real world and with mixed reality world. They offer a 52-degree field of view and weigh only 88 grams. They come with a computing pack and controller, but can also be tethered to a smartphone. And perhaps the best part about the nreal Light MR glasses is that they come as a computer kit package too. With the development of these many XR devices, the future technology in general looks very bright. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.